Can Learn a Lot from an Apple Tree. Written by Beth Costanzo. Illustrated by Ekaterina Elina. The Adventures of Scuba Jack. Copyright 2020 by Beth Costanzo. Hope stretched out her legs and pointed her toes upwards as she tried to go higher and higher. Her long, brown, curly hair trailed behind her on the fast-moving swing. "Faster!" she yelled. Being up in the air was like flying, and from there, she could see the entire countryside. Above the swing was a large treehouse, perfect for all the incredible adventures that she would read about in her next book. Henry, her younger brother, ran around the tree with his toy sword raised high in the air, as if he was going into battle.
"I'm a knight and will rescue the beautiful princess. I won't let any dragon carry her away."
Mom walked over to the tree and sat down with Hope and Henry. "Hope," she said, "this tree has been here for over 100 years and has weathered a lot of storms. I played on it when I was young, just like you. I loved her companionship, and I always felt welcome and calm in her presence. Did you know this tree is special and magical?"
"How is the tree magical?" asked Hope.
"Like many trees, our tree provides the oxygen that we need to breathe, giving life to our planet. It also gives us food and provides a home to countless creatures."
"Wow, that is magical," said Hope.
"I noticed our tree changes throughout the year. In springtime, our apple tree has beautiful white blossoms.
They make our yard smell beautiful. After it rains, Henry and I go outside with our boots and umbrellas, and I look for rainbows," added Hope.
"What do you think our tree gives us in the summer?" asked Mom.
"I know," said Henry. "The apple tree gives us shade to keep us cool during the hot summer days."
"I like to sit in my treehouse and read my favorite stories," said Hope. "Then at night, I like to watch the fireflies dance around the yard with a warm amber glow. If I am lucky, I may see a shooting star take flight across the beautiful night sky."
"I love my tree, and I know she loves me," said Hope.
"What about during the fall season?" asked Mom.
"Apples, apples, apples," said Hope. "We grab baskets and collect apples from our tree. It's so amazing that the blossoms turned into apples."
"Mom," said Henry, "you make us apple pie in the fall and serve it with ice cream. It's delicious."
"On Halloween," said Hope, "I show our tree my beautiful costumes. I love the bursts of fiery red, yellow, and orange colors of her leaves. Fall is like nature's been saving up all year for the grand finale."
"Let's go in. It's time for dinner," Mom announced. A month later, a cold east wind blew all the remaining leaves off the apple tree. Winter had finally arrived. Hope and Henry wanted to go outside and play, but Mom told them it was just too cold. Mom did not want them to get a chill or get sick.
"Mom," Hope cried, "I miss my tree. I can't go outside and hug her. I can't tell her all my secrets. I can't tell her I love her."
"One day it won't be so bitterly cold," said Mom. Hope continued,
"I miss visiting my treehouse and reading stories. I didn't get to tell her goodbye."
Several weeks had passed. Hope looked out her window at her friend the apple tree and wondered if they would ever be together again. With no leaves, her tree looked bare and sad. "I wonder if my tree misses me," she thought. Snowflakes drifted by her window, landing softly on the tree branches. Mom walked by and saw Hope looking unhappy.
"You know, we can learn a lot from an apple tree. I love trees because they stand firm even during the harshest of weather. Mom added, "Their branches are like arms, always reaching up for the stars. Always believe in the magic of tomorrow. If you give up when it's winter time, you will miss the promise of spring and the beauty of summer." Hope asked her mom if she and Henry could go outside. "It's warmer today than the past few days, so yes, you can go outside."
"Yippee!" shouted Hope.
"Oh boy!" said Henry.
Hope and Henry quickly put on their coats and ran outside. The sun felt warm on their faces. Hope hugged her friend the tree, and the tree hugged her back. She noticed there were buds on the apple tree branches. Henry saw daffodils sprouting from the flower beds and bugs buzzing through the yard. The birds sang, and the squirrels emerged from the hollow tree in the corner of the yard. Every year the seasons changed, and so did the apple tree. Hope changed too. She was older, and her 8th birthday was in a week. Mom said, "Hope, you are growing up so fast. You don't look like a baby anymore. Life is always changing, and with these changes, you get older and wiser, like the tree." Hope sat beneath her apple tree and thought to herself, "I shouldn't let the sadness of one winter season destroy the joy of the ones yet to come. Because of my tree, I have learned to find happiness in each day. I guess Mom's right. You can learn a lot from an apple tree." Visit us at www.adventuresofscubajack.com. Hope learned that everything changes. Just like her tree, Hope was changing too. And so is everything in existence. She realized not to let the sadness of one season destroy the joy of the new ones yet to come. Happiness is found in each and every day.